morning, all of you. Good morning, all the faculties and my dear students. I welcome all of you in this online project poster presentation competition, which is organized by Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering in collaboration with IIT Saki under Oscillations 2021. This has been our parampara, that every year we organize such kind of a poster, project poster competition, wherein our students get to present their project in a very innovative manner, in a creative manner, and this makes them prepared for any other competitions which are going to be held inter-college based or inter-departmental based or any other competitions which are organized all around the world, around the country, and under Mumbai University. So this also gives opportunity for third year students who are entering into their final year to see how, what kind of work is getting done by this seniors, and so they can either improve their work or they can also continue with the work which is already going on. So I welcome you all in this poster presentation, and hereby I hand over to our HOD, Ms. Vinita TV, to share some words regarding this project poster competition. Vinita ma'am, over to you.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, you are on. Vinita ma'am.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Sorry, I could unmute the mic. Good morning to all of you, dear students and faculties. As our norm of EXCC, as Gauri madam told, each year we are keeping project poster presentation with intention of giving a platform for students' hard work which they have done over 1 year on the project to showcase it and get inputs from all the faculties. And we have seen over the years that this stage will groom them up to the, in a very fine way, to the next exam, that is project exam, which they are going to present before external examiners. And in previous years we have all the comments from examiners that your department projects are very nice and students are presenting very well. This was possible because they had presented here before our own faculties and their juniors. And in the physical platform, there was much this option for more interaction. But nevertheless, this online platform, we are now used to it from last 1 year, and we hope that this will also give enough space for interaction. So my request for PE students, that you interrupt them and ask in the question, of course, in the question answer session period that will be declared to you, that you ask any queries relevant, technical queries, are about the project implementation or about the title which you feel relevant, and even if you have any inputs regarding that technicality or anything, please you can pass it on. So that will make your knowledge about the project and choosing the right this project statement and implementing how much is required for one BE project, these all things will be somewhat clear to third year students also. We have asked some of the interested second year students also to join so that now this all years of department, that is second year, third year and all, are having mini projects or course projects in the revised curriculum, and it will be beneficial for them to look from this perspective. And for your information students, 2-3 years back, whichever their final year projects, many of them we are seeing now as mini project titles, slightly modified. So what does it show to you? That 1 year project work that was being done, now due to the advancement in technology, you can implement it as a mini project, because already due to the availability of many code modules or the even the new statements which we feel in this year will become little bit already many people have tried in the coming 2 years. And also these forums will become a path for us, for both you students and us, to identify some of the statements which can go up to patent our product or copyright or this thing. So in that sense, I wish the whole department for the successful event. And this is being declared under oscillations of IETE, which they are, IETE Mumbai is organizing oscillations as from January to April every year. And with a special request to IET Mumbai, they agreed to include this event, which is in the beginning of the May month also, into the oscillations 2021. Okay, so best wishes for all the students to present it very nicely.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for encouraging the students. Now, I would just like to have a quick recap of all the rules and regulations that project groups need to follow. Okay, so in the first slot, that is this morning slot, first 9 groups will be presenting, and in the afternoon slot, 2 p.m. to 3:30 p.m., the 10th to 19th group will be present. Then it is compulsory for all the students to have only 10 minutes presentation, okay, by sharing their screen. Maximum 2 group members will be presenting the entire presentation, and others can participate into question and answer period. Then we have some expert panel to judge this poster, okay, and they can also show their project work via a small video or by live streaming. Okay, so now by wrapping up with the all rules and regulations, I request project group number 1, that is sentiment analysis of the Mahabharata corpus by Hitesh Kumar Jain, Vedant Madne, Tarang Agle and Vinod Kumar Nuleva, whose internal guide is Vinutama. So students, over to you. You can share your screen now.
I think Tarang Agle is also part of the group.
Yes, ma'am. Tarang is also there. Yes,
ma'am. Is the screen visible?
Not at present. Yeah, now it is visible.
Okay, so I would like to start the this is our poster. We will start with the abstract. So wide range of emotions have been covered in the Mahabharata. So we are seeing that whether we can write some program that would catch those emotions when they change, how quickly they change from one end to the other. So our domain is actually called as NLP, which stands for Natural Language Processing. We will be dealing with the written text, that is the data is in the text format. So polarity, which I told you, is how quickly the sentiments change from one end to the another. Suddenly it is a happy day but it started raining. So between these two sentences we will get the maximum polarity. For our project in particular, what we want to do is try to fit the already available algorithms, some of which like our scikit-learn's count vectorizer or TF-IDF vectorizer, and see which one gives us reliable results on our particular data. So this is a 150-year-old translation of the Mahabharata, and what we are trying to do is plot on the y-axis how negative or positive the sentiments are for each sentence, and on the y-axis how opinionated the sentence are, or if they are just plain, just stating something, today this happened, these are the events going on. So then it is, then we are calling it as fact and giving it a low score. So we can see there are 18 boroughs, we have plotted them in relation to each other. These points you can see, these are relative to the each parwa. We see that the Shanti parwa is the most opinionated, means people are giving their heartfelt opinions instead of just stating the order of events. Next, this is the overall workflow we have tried to follow. So we have used a circle instead of a flow chart because this is not linear progression. First we do some text processing. Actually 80% of any NLP project goes here, because you go to do topic modeling, you use we found NDA gave us the best reliable result which matched with intuition. We tried this latent semantic analysis and RAKE. We did not try non-negative matrix factorization, but out of these three we found that LDA gave us reliable result. So why we were not getting reliable result? For that we have to come back again to text pre-processing, do some steps there, and then try again whether we can improve our results. So mainly we have used rule-based algorithms as opposed to rule-based algorithms. They are also ML algorithms, but for that we need datasets which are specific to our field, whether it is medical or telecom, or here we are doing basically dealing with Indian English. So what the sentiment scores we have plotted for each and every sentence of the Mahabharata. Tomorrow someone may use this and make a train test model which will use ML based algorithms as opposed to rule based which we have used. So these are some of the results. We try to plot word clouds. So here is the name of the parva. Like this, there are 18 parvas. The order is 1, 2, 3, and this is the 18th month over here. So after removing stop words such as A and the words which don't give us much meaning, these are the main words that give us the gist of each parva. So basically Adi Parva tells what happens in the main text. So we can see the future tense shall is the most common word in the Adi Parva. Similarly, main insight we got is for the Drona Parva, the next Senapati is the main character person in that Parva. So if Karna is the Senapati in Karna Parva, he is the most talked about because he is the future candidate who is going to be the Senapati in the war. So everybody is discussing him in the previous parva. This was another insight we were able to garner. Before we dig deep into this like this, this is a basic topic modeling. This is part of topic modeling which we did, which was count the number of unique words in each parva to get its vocabulary. So we can correlate here. You can see that Karna parva is actually the shortest parva and it has a least number of unique words also. So like this, these are zero index, so you can see 17 only, but it is starting from zero, so there are 18 parvas. Next we have honorifics. So we try to understand how was the society during the Mahabharata time. So people were very much attached to their occupations. When greeting each other, especially in formal settings, they used the whole title of that person whom they were greeting, whether it was just an administrator or a king. So we find out Krishna is never addressed as a king, although he was one of many Lokpalas of Dwarka. So this is just to give you a flavor. We plotted this for each and every parva. Here we are giving you the Sabha parva because it is very eventful. Here you see the Shishupal world. How quickly the content gets polarized and the assembly, Yudhishthira's, Rajasya sacrifice assemblies.
Vedant, you are not audible.
How long was I muted?
5 seconds.
Yes.
Okay.
All the students can note that don't do like this. It is a online competition. Don't mute anyone. Otherwise, we have to change the settings.
So this we were able to do is auto summarize. We wrote a program. You can check it on our project website. If you go to our project website, you can, this is more interactive version. If you click, you can see the code of each part of the work we have done. So you can check the code there. So you can just enter any page of the Mahabharata and it will summarize that whole page in 3 sentences. So this is the Anudyut. This is, you see, between the Anudyut and Dyut, things become unpolarized again. Everybody is amicable with each other until Draupadi Vastraharan Parva, where again things become extremely polarized. And the last is when the Pandavas accept forest exile. Just when they accept forest exile, the people get amicable and everybody is happy with the situation. Of course, except the Pandavas. So what are the main things we covered here? First, we cleaned our data. So there are many conventions followed while writing the text, while processing it, that we have to get rid of actually, so our computer can read it. We have to convert it into JavaScript object notation format so that our computer can understand it. And we have to then pickle it, serializing, so we can reuse it again and again without putting a huge load on the memory. Speaking of memory, there are 1.2 million words in the text we analyzed, and we did actually this term frequency inverse document frequency matrix. So if we could show you, it creates a sparse matrix. Sparse matrix means most numbers are zeros over there. If it doesn't occur in each of the parva, if it occurs in the parva, we put a 1 over there, like this we did in the TF-IDF matrix. It other than that, we did hashing. So instead of storing 1.2 million words in memory, we counted the unique number of words and gave them positional arguments. So we stored a unique word in memory only once. Another thing is, we only used SPACY. It was not trained on the Indian English which we use. So it was tagging, which were actually names of places called as geopolitical entities, as people names, and some people names were getting tagged as names of places. So tomorrow someone can use our dataset to actually do the tagging for Indian English. So this issue can be resolved. Then we used Jensen's topic, with the help of Jensen we do topic modeling. As we showed here, LDA, latent Dirichlet allocation algorithm, gave us best result. Then we used 2 approaches to sentiment analysis. We used the text log path as well as NLTK. Both gave us almost similar results, but the computational efficiency of SPACY was higher. For word club, we had to wait for about 2.5 hours for the whole word to get done.
Last 1 minute, okay?
Okay. So these are some other things. Frequency-based embeddings is the, if the word occurs more, it gets a higher importance. Then we used scikit-learn's count vectorizers to vectorize the text. TF-IDA factorizer, and there is also TF-IDA transformer, but we found for our purpose TF-IDA factorizer was better. That's it. And 50,000 were unique words which occurred only once out of 1.2 million words. That's all.
Thank you, Veda. Now this is question and answer hour. Yes, students and faculties, I request for your questions.
Gauri madam.
Yes.
Okay, I am going to ask him.
Yes.
Vedan, I want to ask you why you choose only Mahabharata topic for natural language processing.
Yes, there are two main reasons. One is that if we can perform sentiment analysis on the Mahabharata, then it is basically a proof of concept that if such a large text can be analyzed, then any other text can also be analyzed with relative simplicity. That is one thing. And the second thing is for content in Indian languages, although there are, if you see, there are 1 lakh registered newspapers in India alone, but because the which is highest for any country, but because this data is not available for analysis, because it is not digitalized, sometimes there are other problems, it is not in the right format. So all these challenges are there. So if you could inspire someone else to pick up say XYZ newspaper sentiment analysis over the past 50 years. So if somebody did with such an old text as Mahabharata, so anyone else can do it with other texts also in Indian languages. That is the second point.
Okay, and second question is that if you got a chance to present your poster at international platform, so how will you make them understand what is a Mahabharata?
That is the great thing, that many people already have heard about the Mahabharata, because if you combine the two Greek epics, Iliad and Odysseus, and multiply their length by 10 fold, then that is the range of the Mahabharata. So, and it is 4 times the size of the Ramayana. Everybody has heard, if not know who is he, heard of Krishna. Some familiarity is there. So if any you want to introduce an outsider to the challenges faced in processing Indian literature, then I think Mahabharata is the best gateway you can find.
Okay, one more question, Vedan.
Yes,
Before 2 days I read one article on natural language processing. There nowadays we are going through this pandemic situation, and all doctors are giving the prescription on the WhatsApp. Means they are writing their prescription on their letterhead and sending on WhatsApp. So basically what is happening, a patient is not able to read what doctor has written. So for such cases, can you use your natural language processing technique?
That is called as OCR, optical character recognition. So you write something, scribble something on the paper, and for that is part of image processing, and for that we need GANs, generative adversarial networks. What that is part of machine learning, what it does is recognize patterns in the written text. So this is already in a typed format, it was written on a typewriter. So we did not have to face that challenge, but if anyone wants to do that, they should look at Abby Fine Readers OCR. Or also there is OpenCV is another library which they can do for processing written text which has been scanned.
Yes, it is already in digital format only in WhatsApp image.
Yes, but it is in image format.
I read about natural language processing can be possible for the image.
Yes, it is possible. But first step in data cleaning, here one more step will be added, and that step will be called as OCR, optical content recognition. So this is being used. So for example, earlier Marathi was until Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj gave it a software upgrade, it was written in Modi Lipi and not Devanagari Lipi. So we have text in Modi Lipi, but very few people can actually read that script. So OCR has been used, is being used. There was one project in IIT Bombay, I don't know if it is going on, to recognize these characters and map them to the Devanagari writing system.
Okay, Vedant, thank you.
Are there any questions from students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Vedant, did you try this your algorithm on different database like Twitter? Okay, is it going to work on the other database or only you designed for Mahabharata?
We used the already existing algorithm. So the flowchart and the algorithm is already there. We did not make any new algorithm. These are the names of the algorithm. But at every step, we had to go back and rewrite some lines, if we could show you, so that it is more suitable for our text. So when it was tagging names of people as a GPE, geopolitical entity, as names of people, places, so we had to edit the spaced pipeline. Space is very customizable this way. So we edited the spaced pipeline and removed the default NER recognition. And actually, by removing some the NER named entity recognition pipe in the spaced pipeline, we were able to get a more meta result. So we are not invented any algorithm. We are already using algorithms that are available.
Okay, but I think you must try this with the different database. Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir. We will try. Thank you for your suggestion. We will take it.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, Vedant. Now I call upon the second group, that is, of object detection over real-time video streaming by Sahil Shah, Dhruv Satra, Tahir Dilwala, and Jenny Devia, whose internal guide is Dilipanha and Bhushan Pawasa. Group number two. Over to you. Your 10 minutes are starting from now.
Good morning, ma'am. You can hear us, right?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah,